One property that can be really helpful when you're trying to solve linear equations is something called the addition property. And it goes something like this. It says, if two expressions are equal to each other, if A equals B, then for any value n, if you add n to the left-hand side A and also add n to the left-hand side B, the equality is maintained, right? So the t sides are still equal. And a good way to think about this is on a scale. A scale will tip if you put more weight on one side or just on the other side. So here, if we have A on one side and we have B on the other side, if we increased the left-hand side by n, right? So if we put an extra, n pennies or terms or whatever n is representing, if we add extra to the left-hand side but do not add any to the right-hand side, the scale will tip and it won't be equal anymore. The left side won't in fact equal the right side. But if we increase the left side by n and also increase the right-hand side by n at the same time, the scale will still be equal. And this actually has huge implications for how we solve linear equations. Let's think about this for a minute. If we had x minus 5 equals 7, then obviously you and I both know what our goal is here. Our goal is going to be to solve for x, meaning get x isolated by itself on the left-hand side. But right now I have a minus 5, and I sure would love for that minus 5 to go away. And so what we can do is we could add 5 to the left-hand side, because what is minus 5 plus 5? Well, it's 0. And so these would go away and we would only have an x on the left-hand side once these guys canceled. But remember that scale that we talked about. If x minus 5 and 7 are equal to each other, if we increase the left side by 5 but not the right side also, the scale isn't equal anymore. So we can certainly increase the left-hand side by 5, no problems at all with that. But if we add 5 to the left-hand side, we have to remember to also increase the right-hand side by 5 as well, so that this equality is maintained. So minus 5 plus 5 cancel, and 7 plus 5 gives you 12. So here we solve the linear equation by using this addition property to get rid of our minus 5. Now, if we go back to the beginning, the original equation was, if you can read it in white, x minus 5 equals 7. Well, try 12 for x. 12 minus 5 is 7. So we found the solution to this linear equation using the addition property. Let's try one more. Here we have y plus 3.7 equals 14.9. Well, you can actually do something similar to the addition property called the subtraction property. So again, if you're trying to isolate the y here by itself and you have an extra 3.7 that you don't want, then you can decrease the left-hand side by 3.7. And that will lower the left-hand side to where you would only have a y on the left-hand side. But again, if that original equality was here, if we decrease the left-hand side by 3.7 but not the right-hand side, you would not have equality anymore. So let's also decrease the right-hand side by 3.7 at the same time. And y, when these cancel, plus 3.7 minus 3.7, y would equal 11.2. If we subtract these two guys here, 14.9 minus 3.7. And so really this actually is the addition property still, but it's like we're adding a negative quantity, which is in essence subtraction. So anyways, we got our final answer using this addition property. So you can really use this property a lot when you're solving linear equations to move terms around and to move terms to the opposite side of the equal sign by adding or subtracting a certain amount, as long as we remember to do it to both sides of the equation.